Thank you. Did Christopher send you? I'm not sure what the cultist wanted with me, from what little I was able to overhear. It sounds as if they are searching for something that belonged to one of my ancestors, Romani Molini. I did hear them use the name Azarcel a number of times. If that means anything to you, well, since you have dealt with the cultists so efficiently, I believe I can find my own way home. Thank you again for rescuing me.
I told you I'm a genie. I'm so relieved my benefactor was retrieved unharmed. Now I may continue my studies without the worry of financial insolvency.
Take care when Walker. Give me a second to examine these. Interesting. While you were hard at work in Craftsman's Rest, I had the most intriguing conversation with our young genius, Christopher Chettlebell. I'm certain now that the Thayans are attempting to enter the old Waterclog Guild crypts. Something tells me it would be wise to prevent that. The Red Wizards and their Gnoll allies are looting the tombs of Craftsman's Rest, hoping to find the secret of unlocking the Waterclog tomb. Capture any artifacts they have found and bring them to me. Perhaps we can solve this puzzle ourselves.
Miss Monini said her captors spoke of someone named Azazel. I seem to remember coming across that name while researching her family. I need one of my books, The Annals of Neverdeath, to confirm my suspicions. Unfortunately, I lost the book when I made my hasty departure from Craftsman's Rest. As I fled, I saw gnolls tearing open my pack and pawing through the book inside. They did alarming damage to them. Pages were flung everywhere. Please search the artisan's tomb and recover my research materials. We need to know what these cultists are searching for.
You lose!
Nice work. I'll confer with Chettlebell and see if we can make any sense of these.
Ah! You've returned with my book! Oh, it's in such a state! Nevertheless, I must persevere. Let's take a look. Ye gods! Small wonder Valindra and the cult of dragons are fighting each other. Azazel is the name of a blue dragon, and he is imprisoned in the Clockwork Tomb. Apparently, Miss Monini's ancestor was both a powerful member of the Water Clock Makers Guild and a dragon cultist with the Ring of Dragon Control. When he died, he gave orders for the dragon Azazel to be entombed with him. You really must deal with Azazel before Valindra or the cultists gain control of him. Harper Windle has knowledge of the tomb's physical locks, but there is also a metaphysical one. I'm afraid you will have to travel to the Shadowfell to trip this final lock. Add this powder to the eternal flame in Craftsman's Rest to open a portal to the Shadowfell.
Chettlebell fills me in about the dragon. I'm sure you know how bad it would be if that dragon gets loose, or worse yet, falls under Valindra's control. According to Chettlebell, the way into the Waterclock Guild Tomb is locked by a complex mechanism. Multiple physical seals must be activated before you can enter. Valindra's minions don't know about this, so they are trying to enter the tomb by force. That gives you a chance to get there first. But you need to activate those seals. right. Let's hope you get into the Waterclock tombs before Valindra.
Excellent! Once the physical seals are taken care of, you should be able to enter the Waterclaw Guild tomb. Excellent! You should be able to enter the Clockwork tomb via the main entrance now. You'd best hurry. Harper Windle's spies report that Valindra's troops are close to breaking through into the tomb. If Valindra gets her hands on the Cult of the Dragon artifacts buried with Romani Manini and frees Azazel, it bodes ill for Neverwinter, and yours truly, of course.
Stop. dragons! Oh, hello again. Your friend is well, I hope. Have fun.
I told you I'm a genius. Valinder escaped with Azazel. Perhaps it's time to visit my academic colleagues in Waterdeep. I suppose you could consider the bright side. Now that Valinder controls an army of gnolls and undead and a blue dragon, it's highly unlikely she will simply go away and leave Neverwinter in peace. I'm sure you'll get another chance to set things right. In the meantime, I must make travel arrangements.
take care when walking about the graveyard, adventurer. Valindra's undead and the Court of the Dragon are no longer a threat here in Neverdam. And we have you to thank. Valindra escaping with the right of the Dracolich, however, is certainly a setback. We're sure to see her again, though it may take us some time yet to gather the necessary components. We'll be able to keep Neverdeath under control for now. I'm sure Nox will want to hear all about today's events.
Protector's enclave. So, Valindra escaped with a dragon. And something called the Rite of the Dracolich. Oh, That pretty much guarantees we haven't seen the last of her. But you did thwart the Thayan's plans in Neverdeath, and that means we'll have a lot fewer undead threatening the city. Well done!
With the issues in Neverdeath put to rest, it is high time for you to enjoy the fruits of your efforts. I have arranged for you to speak with several individuals.
If you have any questions, please let me know.
Do you require my assistance? So, you wish to learn to invoke the power of the gods? Invocation is a powerful skill, which you may use in any rest zone. Whenever you invoke, you will receive gifts for your devotion. Try it now and receive the favor of the...
Do you need something? If you need a companion or have any questions about companions, then you've come to the right place, my friend. Companions will fight with you, heal you, and help you in all of your adventures. Companions come in different levels of quality, which you can upgrade over time. You can even give them equipment to use. That's not all you can do with companions, however. Each companion will increase the bolster rating of other companions in that group, adding to their power. Excellent. We have several companions available to you, courtesy of Lord Neverember. I will gladly tell you all I can. The apprentice healer is skilled. you need something? Companions will fight with. Most active bonuses will increase your personal abilities, such as adding to your chance to critical hit or take less damage from attacks. Some active bonuses will trigger randomly from your attacks, doing various things like more damage or healing you. You should definitely look through your available companions and select the right companions to join your active band.
Hello there! What can... You can equip your companion with rings, belts, and other pieces of gear that is crafted specifically for them. If you happen to come across any in your travels, it would be worth your while to place them in your companion's gear.
So you wish to learn about seals. So be it. During your travels, you have perhaps come across seals, or seen one or two merchants who deal with them. If you have enough of these seals, merchants will sell you wares specific to the area that you are in.
Sometimes you will need to work with other adventurers to overcome challenges. Dungeons, skirmishes, and trials are more dangerous, but offer greater rewards. In an effort to help bring together those who seek these challenges, the mages of the Adventurers Guild have created a means to match parties together for travel in the darker realms of Faerun. Now that you've learned about lockboxes, invocations, seals, companions, and cues, it is time for you to set out once more. A forsworn member of the Grey Wolf tribe has asked for help in reclaiming the honor of his people. It would certainly benefit Neverwinter to gain the goodwill of at least some of the Oathgard barbarians. Speak with Thalos Oathbreaker at the Forsworn Camp in Velosk. But be warned, that area is under the control of the Netherese. Their war with the Thayans means Valindra could be involved. And I've heard rumor that the Thayans are up to something there.
Good. What ails you?
Have you come to help us regain our honor? Fallen on hard times from the strife in this land. Some are too proud to ask for aid, but I trust you can ease our suffering. Speak with our tribe's wolf trainer and see what you can do for her. The Grey Wolf who follow the Netherese have begun to worship aspects of their dark gods in the guise of Uthgar. The Dark Hunter is nothing more than an aspect of Shar the Night Mistress, who hunts in shadows and kills without mercy. Worship of the Dark Hunter is an affront to Uthgar the Battlefather. Travel the road west and north of the Forsworn camp. At the end of Hunter's Path, you will find the Cursed Grove. Destroy any shadow totems you find there.
When the Grey Wolf tribe catch our Forsworn brethren, no mercy is shown. The victims are bound to sacrificial stones and tortured to death. The screams of the dying serve as a warning to others who would oppose the Netherese. One of our hunting parties was recently killed in this manner. They must not be forgotten. At the stones of sacrifice west of Forsworn camp, you will find the corpses of our fallen people. Retrieve the ancestor necklaces from the corpses of the brothers Ragnar, Belrak, and Davian. Return them to the cairn of the honored dead on the south side of the Forsworn camp.
What are you looking at? Yes, I'm injured. I can't hunt, and my poor wolves are hungry. I would let them go out and hunt by themselves, but I fear for their safety. You want to help? Well, if you find yourself fighting werewolves, they're often carrying food, usually fresh meat. If you can find enough fresh meat to feed my wolves, I'll reward you however I can.